Chavez. Number 32, and I play inside linebacker. Some of the best things this season was we had a really good winning season. We were 9-3 overall. We made it to the playoffs. We won by district champions. We got to play a good team in Amarillo, and on the downside, we came up short against them. Some of the other bad things were that we missed out on two games. One, our first game of the season against Hanks because he got rained out, and another because of the September 11 bombings. We would have played Austin. Also, we came up real short. We came up short against our rivals, Riverside, by 6 points. We lost that one. It was a really good game, but I felt that we should have came out on top.
I wake up every morning, jumping at whistles, come rain or shine.
My name is Ricky Najera, I'm quarterback number 8. Going into the Hanks game, we were really excited because it was our first game of our senior season. And it was very disappointing that it ended, you know, with the rain and the game got canceled. But, you know, it was exciting for me because that was the day that I met my biological father. And, of course, I wanted to win that game for him. I wasn't able to, so that was real disappointing.
Ysleta at Bowie versus Jefferson High School. The crowd from Ysleta is ready for a defeat. Ysleta knew that Hank's game did not count. So as of that day, there are one game behind. And the return of Ricky Najera, George Rodriguez, Josh Kane, Eddie Chavez, and many more, they come to show everyone their mental and physical ability. And Jefferson was the first team to prove it.
When we played Jefferson, we didn't know as a team how good our offense and our defense was going to be. And we believe that Jefferson was a very good test for us. And it was a crazy night because coach kept calling in the plays and I kept calling the wrong ones. And what was funny about it that we scored on the first touchdown that we scored on was the wrong play that I called. So that was pretty funny. And we felt like that game was won because, you know, everything was pretty much going for us.
This was the first home game for the Indians. After the September 11th terrorist attack, all the games has been canceled, so the Indians did not have a chance to play against Austin. So the third game they played was against the America's Trailblazers. In the first quarter, the Indians struggled against America's.
When we played America's, like our season was feeling kind of weird because we were playing 1 week and then 1 week we wouldn't play and then we play again and then another 1 week we were off. So it was, I think that we messed up because we didn't prepare ourselves for that game. And Dominica's was a good team and they, you know, they deserved to win. We messed up and that was it.
In the second quarter, the Indians continued to struggle.
Our offense had a chance to score maybe like on the 15-yard line and fumbled the ball.
Later in the second quarter, the Indians saw some daylight. By the interception of number 21, this gave the Indians a chance to score. Then a touchdown by George Rodriguez put number 7 on the scoreboard. Then number 11 made a major comeback from the Trailblazers and made him score for another point on the scoreboard. This was major luck for the Indians when they made this touchdown. But still, the Indians had lost against the Trailblazers, 14-28. The Indians prepare themselves for a big game. They play the undefeated Mountain View Lobos. The Indians lost last year against the Austin Panthers. This year, the seniors want to beat their last and final homecoming game.
David Alba, and I played defensive back from number 24. Homecoming, it's been about 3, maybe 4 years, I'm not sure. But if anybody's won a homecoming game here, especially against Mountain View, they upset us about 2 years ago, maybe last year here at home, had another homecoming. And last year, for a fact, we lost to Austin Hines for our homecoming. Homecoming has just been a disaster here at Ysleta High School, but this was our year.
The Ysleta Indians ended the winning streak for the Mountain View Lobos. The score was 35-7.
From that play, however, later in the fourth, it's Gonzalez again going for the bomb. Wait, wrong team. Ysleta, Joey Lamas Jr. for the interception. He runs it all the way in. Mountain View not having the best.
Our first district game was against El Paso High, and that game was pretty much the George Rodriguez show. It was awesome watching him run. I think he went over 300 yards rushing, and that game was also pretty much over by the first half. And in the second half, coach put in our red team guys, and they did an awesome job. I think they ended up scoring 21 more points, and that was cool.
Touchdown!
football in America is a special game, a unique game. The men who play it make it so. All of them are fearless. All of them are strong, quick, and all of them are part of a story that began long ago. A story written by men who found in a sport a demanding measure for their own courage and ability.
This was a terrible night for the El Paso Tigers. Almost every time when the Indians had the ball, they scored a touchdown. George Rodriguez, number 22, scored most of the touchdowns. But still, this game will always be remembered by the audiences, and especially the football team. This was the best performance of Ysleta High School yet, and the press called this the game of the week. According to the press, this was an outstanding game for the Ysleta Indians, with the great performances from Ricky Najera, George Rodriguez, and Eddie Chavez. And of course, an outstanding score, 73-20. The second district game was against the Bowie Bears. This was another challenge for the Ysleta Indians. This game was all about the offense and the defense. According to some of the students from Bowie High School, they said that the Bowie Bears have improved, so no one did not know if Ysleta Indians were going to win tonight. But in the beginning of the game, the Indians showed a little something to the Bowie Bears. Not only did George Rodriguez make a score, also number 11, Manny Rubacalba, and number 7, Chris Vitella. The defense did an outrageous job for the Indians. They stopped the Bowie Bears from scoring during the whole game. The only time the Bears scored was in the last quarter.
In that game, our receivers pretty much were the ones putting on the show that night. And of course, George Rodriguez, he puts on a show in every game. And Bowie was not able to do anything to our defense simply because they concentrated too much on the run. And when we got ahead, I think it was a score 35-0, I believe, that since they ran the ball so much, they couldn't throw the ball on our secondary guys with David Alva, Eddie Arzola, Tony Flores, and Joey Lamas. Those guys are awesome. They're pretty fast, and so they weren't able to throw any passes, and that's how we beat Bowie, I believe.
fire!
Parking had one guy that we had to stop, and David Alba and Tony Flores did an awesome job on keeping their hands on Michael Jefferson. And when they couldn't pass, they tried to run it, but with Larry Jones and Josh Kane, Ozzy and Bader, those guys were awesome in that game. And I think Larry Jones got a few hits on that little running back. So, and they couldn't do anything to our defense. Our defense was what won that game that night.
As the district game continues, all the opponents for the Indians get harder and harder. But still, this game against Parkland was a very, very good game for the Indians. Parkland was no match for the Ysleta defense. So from the start of the game, the defense and the offense of the Indians did a tremendous great job. Also from the beginning of the game, the Indians looked at Michael Jefferson. He is one of the starters from the Parkland Matadors. From this point, the Matadors were doing a very great job in the season. Because of Michael Jefferson, he's the one that led the Parkland almost to undefeated. But the Ysleta Indians were ready to stop Michael Jefferson. With more performances by Ricky Najera, George Rodriguez, Manny Rubalcaba, and many, many, many more, especially the defense with Ozzy, Josh Kane, and Larry Jones. The Indians had a lot of confidence. They needed to win all their games to have a match with Riverside, because Riverside is also undefeated. The Parkland Matadors offense tried to do their best to go against the defense of the Ysleta Indians, but the Matadors lost to Ysleta High School. Ysleta 31, Parkland 6.
I'm sitting here, a magic chair, without marrying, and I don't care. So far, so good, that's what I hear. Nothing slows me down.
Alright, when we played Burgess, that was a very nerve-wracking game. I don't think I've ever played in a game that exciting. Into overtime, and our defense, honestly, they won that game for us, because Burgess had the ball. I think it was at our 10-yard line, and then they ended up being at the 4-yard line, and then from there, our offense took over, and George worked his magic from there. He scored from, I think it was 10 yards out of the end zone, and that was it, and that's what set us up for the district game against Riverside.
Once again, go!
once again for the Renegade Master. D4 Damage up, the ill behavior's back once again for the Renegade Master. D4 Damage up, power to the people's back once again for the Renegade Master. D4 Damage up, the ill behavior's back once again for the Renegade Master. D4 Damage up, power to the people's back once again for the Renegade Master. D4 Damage up, the ill behavior's back once again for the Renegade Master.
Burgess at Ysleta was a very, very, very outstanding game. This was a game where they put the audience in the edge of their seats. This game was second to the last game for the Ysleta Indians. So as of right now, they remain undefeated in the district. Everyone had a spotlight in this game. No one didn't have a clue who was going to win this game. This was a game for the Ysleta Indians and the Burgess Mustangs. The game started out with the Ysleta Indians first scoring the touchdown. Then in the second quarter, the Burgess Mustangs scored and made 7-7, tied. After that, the Ysleta Indians had scored again, which led them to the fourth quarter. There were 6 seconds left in the game. The score was 14-8. If the Mustangs score, it would have been 14-14, plus the field goal, 14-15. The Mustangs had a chance to score, but the defense of the Ysleta Indians put pressure on the offense and caused them to have a fumble. The Ysleta Indians had won the game in overtime, 20-14. Now the undefeated Ysleta Indian faces the undefeated Riverside Rangers next week.
with the Riverside game, we knew that their running back Carlos Carrillo, he was going to be very hard to stop. No one in El Paso had been close to stopping him, so we knew it was going to be a very good game. And then, you know, at halftime, they were winning by 8 points, and some of our guys, they felt like, you know, the game was pretty much over. And coach came in, and they just told us to settle down. And the second half was very exciting, and our defense, they played their hearts out in that game. And you know, Carrillo is just too much for us, and he's the one that beat us. And that's it.
This is an important game for the Ysleta Indians. These two teams are rivalries. Everyone was waiting for this game, the last and final district game. Who will win it? Who will lose it? No one knows until the end. The Ysleta Indians have their special guy, George Rodriguez, and the Riverside Rangers has their special guy, Carlos Carrillo. George Rodriguez and Carlos Carrillo are the stars of El Paso. Them two has been scoring most of the touchdowns this season. The Riverside Rangers ended up scoring first, then scored again, but then missed the field goal. Following, the Indians scored the first touchdown. The Ysleta defense was ready for Carlos Carrillo. They stopped him a couple of times. Also, the Riverside Rangers were ready for George Rodriguez. Whoever wins this game will get the district title. The Indians did an outstanding job, but the Ysleta Indians had lost. Ysleta 28, Riverside 35.
Thank you.
Okay, our bi-district game against Mountain View, that was another good game. And you know, in the first quarter, we were throwing the ball a lot. Was pretty much we were beating their defensive backs. And David Alva got a touchdown pass. And then you know, George Rodriguez was running pretty good in the first half. In the second quarter, they kind of made up a run, and they kept us quiet pretty much the second quarter. And at halftime, you know, coach was telling us to go out there and just put this game away already. And you know, and that's what we did. In our defense, they stopped Joy Amaya, which was probably one of the best running backs in the city. And I think he only gained about maybe 35 yards rushing, so that, you know, that helps a lot. And then late in the game, it was just George Rodriguez just running the ball. And I think that's the game where I think I went over 100 yards rushing. So I don't think we need to throw the ball in that game. Our our game against Palo Duro, you know, we tried our best against those guys, and they had a good team. They honestly did. They had some big fullbacks and some running backs. I think all their linebackers were playing running back, so they were pretty quick. And that's why we, at times, we were able to run the ball, and then I think throwing the ball, we didn't throw the ball that much simply because they were fast. I think their corner was about 6'4", and he ran about 4'3", so that guy was awesome. And then, you know, they were way too much for us. We couldn't take them, and that's why we lost. They're just too powerful for us. Watch them.
With lungs that gasp for breath from emotional stress with special effects. In a distorted collage, carefully lies between beats of the rhythmic garage. It's going down, a logical progression on a timeline. The separation narrowed down to a fine line. To blur the edges so they blend together properly. Take you on an audible odyssey. Now it's going down, a logical progression on the timeline. The separation narrowed down to a fine line.